Hello, Jenny Hall here for Honeybee Stamps. Today I'll be demonstrating how to do easy no-line watercolor with the freshly picked stamps and dies, Perfect Sentiment stamps and dies, and May the Mouse stamp set and dies. For my scene, I'll be using the Hill Borders dies and the Farm Fence die set. The Farm Fence die set comes with two pieces to put together. One is the base of the fence, and the other side has five pickets. They have a little contour on them, so liquid glue works perfectly just to adhere them together. Now I'm going to stamp May the Mouse, and she is so precious. I'm stamping her with fade out ink from Ink on 3 onto Bristol paper. Bristol paper is key to using Zig Clean Color Real Brush pens, which I plan to use for no-line watercoloring. As you can see, I am double stamping all of the images. Sometimes a third application of ink is even helpful. I use it sometimes because I have poor eyesight. Now I'm going to add my darkest of two different colors around the outside edge of that image. And if you look closely, you can see that the fade out ink from Ink on 3 absorbs the color and intensifies the stamped image. So I'm using my darker color to create those natural contours. I'll do the same thing with the strawberry leaves and stem, using that darkest marker or pen over the stamped line, and then pulling out and fading in, going over that dark line with a lighter pen. And I'm trying to use a few white spaces too, and then use the Zig Empty Blender to go in and just kind of make a little bit of a highlight contour. I'm going to color all the rest of the strawberries off camera because that's a lot of coloring. Now moving on to May the Mouse, and I have to tell you guys, she is so precious. I can imagine using her in so many different scenes. Today she is all about fresh strawberries. So I'm going to use a few different gray pens and one of the pink pens. And if you can see that I am adding only a certain amount of color and then using that, I think it's number 999. I'll be sure to put it in the video description, but it's the Zig solution, but it has no color. It just has a white cap, a white end, and it takes and blends out the color that's added to the paper and then spreads it out. This gives me a natural looking contour to the mouse's face and to the mouse's ears. And it just works so easily. For no-line watercoloring, the fade-out ink is almost essential. You could use some distress ink that's very light, but I really prefer using the fade-out ink from Ink on 3. The more I've used it, the more I've come to rely upon it. Now I'm going to use that exact same technique by going over the stamped line and then pulling it out with that colorless blender. And then on the belly, I'm just adding a little bit of color because the belly is going to be covered up by a pretty big size strawberry. But just in case anything shows around the berry, I want there to be some kind of color. And I'm using a darker shade on the tail so that it stands out as not being part of the mouse's body. Now I'm going to go over those areas that were stamped that were for the features. The eyes are really easy to see because I double or triple stamped. And then I'm going to go over the mouth and go over the whiskers. I sped this up considerably. I think it was 500 times. And I drew really slowly. So be sure to take your time and get those whiskers and eyes exactly as straight as you like them. Now I'm going to use that Hill Border die on a piece of 80-pound cardstock and I'm just taking the bottom part of the hill border negative space and adding green, and then the top portion is adding blue, distress oxide, and that's going to be the background for my scene. I didn't add any water droplets this time for interest. Instead, I thought it would be nice just to have a perfectly blue sky. Now I'm going to adhere this down to a mat that is 1/8 of an inch larger than the panel that I die cut. That way it will give me a little bit of a nice white border, and I will still be able to adhere these two pieces and keep them secure. Now this unit will go with some double-sided foam tape onto the card base. Here are the two sections that I had put together earlier of the fence, and you can see here that getting creative with this fence is really fun. It's a perfect way to set up a scene. I've got a foreground with the characters, the strawberries, and the fence, and then the background with that die-cut area, and it just worked out so simple. I'm going to add a little piece of foam tape behind the mouse's head and ears just to make sure that it's the same level, because that fence was raised up with a little bit of dimension. Now I'm using liquid glue to add the strawberries, and this is the new liquid glue from Honeybee Stamps. And then we will create our sentiment on black cardstock, and I'll treat that first with an anti-static powder tool. I do tend to get a little bit free with the powder tool when I'm using black cardstock, but that's because I'm being very careful. Now some fine detailed white embossing powder, and then we're going to get that heat set. I neglected to get the whole area heat set, and so the bottom of my Y didn't come out very well. So using a white gel pen really quickly, I was able to go in and just go right back over that area. And then I'll adhere this over the strawberries and fence with some liquid glue. And our scene is coming together nicely. Now I'm going to use some clear rhinestones. These are called wedding ring rhinestones, and they remind me of dewdrops. So I wanted to just have a little bit of clear sparkle that would show up, and nothing too fancy or frilly, just something to catch the eye. I even placed a few of them on the strawberries themselves. I'm using the Marvy Jewel Picker and some more of that precision glue to adhere them down. I hope that you have enjoyed this project. Here's the one we made today, and here's another version that does not have the mouse. You could insert any character or just keep it very simple. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next time.